Welcome to my next online classes of module 4, part 2. In last class, you have come across same module, module 4, part 1, which consists of different types of letters. So in this module, we will cover reading skills and reading comprehension. So what is reading skills? It is the ability of an individual to read, comprehend, and interpret written words on a page of an article or any other reading material. So, what is reading skill? It is the ability of an individual to read and grasp mentally and explain the written words on a page of an article or any other reading material. The possession of a good reading skills will enable the individual to assimilate a written work within a short period while reading. The possession of a good reading. So, individual with a good reading will enable himself or herself to understand the written work within the short period while reading. He or she can understand the work very easily within a short time span. What is the importance of reading skills? It helps develop the mind and imagination and the creative side of a person. So, importance of reading skill, it helps to develop the mind and imagination of the creative side of a person. It helps to improve communication, both written and spoken. So, reading skill helps in the creative side of a person. It helps to build himself in a creative way. Not only that, it improves both in written and spoken communication. It plays an important part in building a good self-image. So, this reading skill plays an important role in building a good self-image. It is a function that is necessary in today's society. It is a function in the sense reading skill is very much necessary in today's society. Next, how to improve your reading skills? So, how to improve your reading skills? We all read. Isn't it? We all read. Right? You have to understand few points how to improve the reading skill, how to improve your reading skills. First point is read aloud. So, first point is read aloud. Read a text, book, passage, or a block in a good speaking voice. So, what you have to do? You have to read a book, a passage, a text in a good speaking voice. Try to be loud, but don't scream. So here it's mentioned as read aloud. It doesn't mean that you have to scream on top of your voice. Screaming is different. Reading loud is different. Read loud, but don't scream. Also try to be loud enough to hear yourself. So you should be loud enough to hear yourself. Some of us, what we do, we read within ourselves. Some students have the habit, they are habituated to read within themselves. So, instead of that, you try to read loud so that you can hear yourself. So, by doing this, what are the benefits? If you do this, what benefits you get? First is, you become more engaged with the information because you are using your eyes and ears. So, when you read loud, you will not close your eyes and ears. So, when you start reading, even we use our eyes and ears and we become more engaged with the information what is written or mentioned there. It helps you in pronunciation because you are going to learn more intently. So when you keep reading, you will be engaged more. Not only that, it helps you in pronunciation because you are listening also. Reading out loud helps your comprehension. So if you read loud, it will improve your comprehension. So these are the benefits of reading loud. Next, read various topics. Next point is read various topics. You will be exposed to try variety of vocabulary words which will improve your reading. If we try various topics, what will happen? It will improve our reading skills and it will improve our words. We get new words to understand and it will help you in reading. You will not be bored about English language because you have various topics to read about. So you will not be bored because you have various topics to read. So you have to go for many topics, different topics, which will not bore you. You will have a desire to read more. So by doing this, by improving your language, what will happen? You will have a desire to read more. You feel like reading more and more. Next is read new words. Read new words. Repeat new words using dictionary and read over and over that you are not familiar with. So if you start reading new words, you will be familiar one day with the words. So what you have to do, repeat new words using a dictionary. So probably you may not be knowing the meaning. Of course, new words means you are not aware of the meaning. So refer dictionary and start finding the meaning and repeat again and again so that you will be familiar with those words. So what are the benefits if you do this? You will be able to recognize which part of the word is difficult to pronounce. So repeating, reading new words will help you to recognize which part of the word is difficult to pronounce. You will gain confidence to say the word which will help you in fluency. See, when you read new words, what happened? You will not be able, it is not that only you can recognize the part of word which is difficult for you to pronounce, but you can get confidence also. You gain confidence to say the word which help you in fluency. So if you want to talk to somebody, you can utilize, you can use these new words and help, which helps you in fluency. You become more familiar with the words. Reading skills is connected with your knowledge and vocabulary, also with your fluency. They go hand in hand. So you become familiar with the words when you go for new words, and reading skills is connected with your knowledge and vocabulary, which will go hand in hand, which go together. Next point is read often. Read often means daily. It is very important to set aside a specific amount of time for reading. First, start up to 5 minutes, then up to 30 minutes. It is very important to set a specific amount of time. See, most of us, we don't read daily. What students do, they just pile up the books and keep after the classes. And at the end of the, when the exams are approaching, you keep reading. Please don't do that. So it is very important to set aside a specific amount of time for reading. First, you can spare 5 minutes, then 10 minutes, then so on so forth. It can go for 30 minutes, 1 hour, and as much as patience you have. So what are the benefits of reading daily? What benefits you get? You will begin to understand and comprehend native speakers. So here, when you read daily, you will begin to understand and comprehend native speakers. Native speakers means those who are from different state, even though they speak English, their language will be affected there. Their language will be affected the way they speak. Okay, so you can understand them easily when you read yourself very often, daily. You will begin to read faster and with more confidence. Not only that, you will begin to read faster and with more confidence. It helps to improve your vocabulary, comprehension, builds confidence. The more you read, the better you get. See, after reading daily, what are the plus points. What are the benefits? One, you will understand the native reader. Next is you will start reading faster and with more confidence. Next, it improves your language and builds confidence in you. The more you read, the better you can. Next, read with a friend. Next point is read with a friend. Find a friend who is also an English learner and pick an English book or log to read together. What do you have to do? You find a friend who is also an English learner who supports you and pick an English blog or a book and read together. Sit together and read. So by doing this, what you find, how you can get the knowledge. You can choose a sentence or a paragraph. This will help you in your listening, your speaking, and your comprehension. See here, this by sitting with your friend and reading will improve your listening, your speaking, and your understanding capacity also. It helps you in all this. So what are the benefits now? What benefits you find reading with a friend? Your desire to read will increase. So when you sit with a friend and read, your desire to read will increase. You recognize how your friend read and you will help them to provide and you will improve your listening skills. So you recognize how your friend read and you will help them to improve and you will improve your listening skills. Not only you improve, even your friend will improve the language. And at the same time, you can improve your listening skills also. Remember, reading will also help you in listening. So this you must keep in your mind. Remember, always reading will also helps you in listening. When you read, obviously, you will listen. It helps in your listening and reading skills both. This method, reading with your friend, will help you in different areas. So reading with your friends help you in different areas. Next point is read 3 times. Here I mentioned 3 times, but if you have patience, if you want to read more, it's fine, well and good. This method requires to read the same word or sentence more than once. However, this method is entirely focused on reading passage or a page more than once. So what does this method require? It requires to read the same word or a sentence more than once. That means you can read for 2 times, thrice, and 4th. How many times you want, you can read. Reading is a very good habit. So by reading this, you can entirely focus on the passage or the matter. Okay. So what are the benefits? What benefits you get if you read this again and again? If you read the paragraph or the sentence or the statement often and more times. This will greatly improve your comprehension skills. So if you read more than once, it will improve your comprehension skills. After reading more than once, you can become familiar with the words. So after reading more than once, you can become familiar with the words which you have come across. So you will become familiar with the words where you have come across. Next, it will help you in proper pronunciation and fluency. It helps you in proper pronunciation and in fluency also. It will help you to recognize and become familiar with new vocabulary words, paras, and sentence structures, which will affect your ability to understand and speak properly. So if you read more time, you can recognize and become familiar with the new words which you are not aware. And the paras and sentence structure, it will definitely affect your ability and you can understand and speak properly. Next is read your level. So what does this mean? Read your level means you have to read any text or book or article, magazine to your level. Suppose you are in 10th standard, if we provide degree or some PhD, like higher semester books, it is not possible for you guys to read. So read your level in the sense, you prefer a book where you can read at least 50%, you can understand. So that will help you to maintain the whole situation over there. Next, this point, read your level means find the English reading material that you can understand after reading briefly. See that you can understand at least 50%. As I told you, see a book, seek a book or an article, anything. And see that you can understand the content of that at least 50%. If you can't try to read or find something else where you can find comfortable. If you can't understand the matter or the material or an article, whatever you are seeking for, if you can't understand, better seek something different where you find comfortable in reading. But keep in your mind, whatever the book or text you read, you must understand at least 50% of that. What are the benefits of this? What are the benefits? You will not feel stressed. See, if you seek the book or material of your level, what benefits we find here? You will not feel stressed. You will improve your reading ability. Sometimes if you read English, you jump too fast. It will not work out. So focus on natural reading level. You will improve steadily and not too quickly. So if you read, you will improve your reading ability. Sometimes if you read English, most of us, what we do, we jump too fast. We jump fast, it will not work out. Or we speak fast. Okay, it will not work out. So focus on natural reading level. Your level must be natural. Don't go too high or too low. And you will improve steadily and not too quickly. By maintaining your reading level, you will improve definitely, but not too quickly. Don't hurry. Since you understand the portion, you will have the desire to read more. So when you understand the portion, you will have the desire to read more. You feel like reading more and more. Next, what is reading comprehension? What is reading comprehension? It is a crucial link to effective reading, which is essential for a rich academic, professional, and personal life. So here, comprehension, reading comprehension means it is a crucial link to effective reading, which is very much required for academic, professional, and personal life. Reading fluency is a very important part of reading comprehension. Yes, students, reading fluency is very important in reading comprehension. If you are not good in reading, if you are not fluent in reading, it will affect your reading comprehension. So here, reading plays a major role. You should be very fluent in reading. As readers who spend their time in decoding words tend to lose their understanding of what is being read. See, many of them, what they do, they start decoding the words which is given to them. So, and they don't understand of what is being read. What will happen? They're going to waste their time there. Reading comprehension. So next, what is reading comprehension? Reading comprehension involves 3 levels of understanding. So this comprehension involves 3 levels of understanding. First is literal meaning reading comprehension. Second is inferential meaning reading comprehension. Next, evaluative meaning reading comprehension. First is, what is literal meaning reading comprehension? What it is? It is the understanding of information and facts directly stated in the text. It is recognized as the first and the most basic level of comprehension in English. See here, literal meaning comprehension means it is the understanding of information and facts which is directly in the text. From the text, what is mentioned in this text, you are going to understand it directly. And it is recognized as the first and the most basic level of comprehension. This literal meaning is considered or recognized as the first and the most basic level of comprehension in reading. That means understanding the text. Students can employ literal comprehension skills to locate better information efficiently. So students can employ literal comprehension skills to locate better information. So to get their better information, they can develop or employ this literal comprehension skills. Next, second one is inferential meaning in reading comprehension skills. What is this? It is the ability to process written information and understand the underlying meaning in the text. Here, what we are doing, it is the information, it is the process of written information and understand the underlying meaning in the text. Means what the meaning is given, the depth in the text. So understanding that caliber or getting that caliber is called as inferential meaning comprehension. This information is used to infer or determine deeper meaning that is not stated. So as I've already told, this information is used to determine deeper meaning or to find out the deeper meaning that is not stated in the text or the material. Inferential comprehension requires readers to combine idea and evaluate. So here, this comprehension reading requires readers to combine their idea and evaluate. Both plays a major role here. Next, what is meant by evaluative meaning reading comprehension? What it is? Evaluative means you are going to evaluate something. What you are going to evaluate? It requires the readers to move beyond the text to consider what they think and believe in relation to the message in the text. See here what we do? Here the readers move beyond the text to consider what they think and believe in it. What the relation it is compared to the text. What the message, how the bonding is between the word and the message given there. So you are going still deeper. You're going beyond the text to consider what is happening there. So next we'll come for causes for poor reading comprehension. What is poor reading comprehension? What causes poor reading comprehension? First point is disinterest and boredom causes not to pay attention to what they are reading. See, first point is disinterest. Means you're not showing interest or boredom when we read or not paying attention will affect our reading comprehension. Next, decoding or individual words slows down or prevents reading comprehension. So second point was decoding. Some of us keep decoding the words which are not familiar or start reading individual words. That means one after the other, one word after the other. If you keep doing this, what will happen? It will slow down. Your reading skills will slow down and prevents reading. It will not entertain you to read further. You will have some problem with such kind of reading. Difficult text challenges some students. Yeah, this is also important. Some texts which are difficult. Text in the sense some words which are in the text challenges some students. In the sense they will not be able to read, understand and speak properly. Next, oral language deficit is often associated with poor reading comprehension. Here, reading comprehension is different and oral language is different. A student who is only good at oral will face the problem with reading comprehension. Working memory deficit occurs who can't remember what they have read long enough. So some of us will have the memory power. Some will not have the memory power. In the sense, if anything is being taught or if you read something which you can't carry for a long time, will also face for poor reading comprehension. It is also a point for losing our reading comprehension skill. Visual process disorders affect students' reading comprehension. So visual process disorders. Visual process means here we get so many meanings. Visual means it is not that only your eyesight. Here we can take for granted even the atmosphere, proper light. Okay, all these things will come under visual disorders where you can't see properly. So this affects students' reading comprehension. First, visual, you have to visual properly, look properly or see everything is okay where you can read. Limited vocabulary can cause poor reading comprehension. Some students will be very particular and very specific of limited vocabulary. So such limited vocabulary will also affect in poor reading comprehension. Decoding difficulties. If the student can't decode the words, they won't know what they are reading. Yes, some of the students have got this problem. They keep decoding the words. This is the, some of them keep breaking, splitting the words. If they don't do this, they will not be able to read or understand what they are doing. So this type of decoding also causes difficulty in poor reading comprehension. This is very important, students. Next, what I'm going to give you is exam tips for reading comprehension skills. So, what are the best tips you want to know when you are reading comprehension skills? A comprehension will be given. So, how you are going to read that and how you are going to work on that? First, budget your time. First is budget your time. Second, divide the passages as per your time. See, when you start writing something in the exam, when a comprehension is given, they will specify a specific time. You have to complete in so and so time. So what you do during that time, budget your time first and divide the passages as per your time. See the time and then divide the passages into two or three or four according to the time given. Try to spend less time on short passages and more time on long passages. So what you do, spend less time on short passages and more time on long passages. Keep track on time. This is very important. When you're doing so, keep track on time. You must keep monitoring the time. It is very important. Without monitoring, without keeping the track, you can't write any exam. Don't read the complete passage from the beginning to the end. Instead, read the heading and subheading and the questions mentioned in the passage. So most of the students, what they do, they start reading from the beginning till the end. Please don't do this. When you are writing the exam for comprehension, when you are writing the exam of comprehension, be careful. Keep this in your mind. Don't read the complete passage from beginning to the end. Instead of that, what you do, read heading, subheading and the questions given in the passage. Read one or two sentences from each paragraph. See, passage is given and what you have done, you have divided into paragraphs, right? So what you do, read one or two sentences from each paragraph and you will get an idea of the passage. This is also very important. So first thing what you have to do, don't read from the beginning till the end. Instead, you can divide the passage into paragraphs, then read the heading and the subheading and the questions given. Later on, start reading one or two sentences from each paragraph. Read the questions always and try to answer the easier one. Underline the main or keywords in a question. So this is also very important. Read the questions always. Read the questions once, twice, thrice until you understand. Try to answer the easier one. Try to answer the easier one. Underline the main or keywords in a question. So most of the questions will contain main words or keywords. Underline them. Okay. Next, don't get stuck to a question where you don't find them. So don't get stuck to a question. So what you have to do, if you are not getting that question, if you are not understanding, just leave that question. If you don't find, leave it off. Go to the next one. If you keep on pondering or looking or gazing at the same question, what you are going to face? If you do so, you will eat up your time. Instead, move to other questions. See, as I've already told, if you keep looking at the same question or if you get stuck with the same question, nothing you are going to gain. Instead, you are going to lose your time. So it's better you can move to other question. How to improve your reading? Best method, how to improve your reading? Two main things which you have to understand. One is your vocabulary. Next is your practice. Struggling in an exam could be one big reason because you lack vocabulary. Reading skills need to be developed. So my dear students, this is very important. Struggling in your exam. You keep struggling in the exam. It is a very big cause. Why? Because you are lacking your vocabulary. That is your reading skill. And it is very important which you have to develop. Next is, solution is read widely. What is the solution for this? Solution is read widely. You have to read with various books, and this helps you to practice. That means if you keep reading again and again with different kinds of books, this will help you to practice.